Okay, thank you. Welcome for the newcomers. I will start the next presentation. Okay. So I will speak about the JFlorovis project, which is a project on flow maps in the JWeb web. I will speak about the project globally, and I will speak about the three parts that composed that project. The corpus we gathered, a survey we made, and the Arabesque web application we are currently developing. So there is three components in that project. We gathered information on current flow visualization web apps, and we gathered it in a corpus, and we studied it a little bit. So I will show you what data we extracted from the corpus. We'll speak about the survey we made to get insight about what are people expecting on flow maps application, and I will speak about the Arabesque web app. So this project is developed by a team of researchers and engineers in geography, computer science, and computer vision. And from the IFSTAR, French Institute of Research on Transportation, Planning, Management, and Networks, and the CNRS, which is a multipurpose, it's a national research center in France. And we had the help of two interns during the summer last year and this summer. So first of all, I'll speak about the corpus. So we gathered information about 79 web applications available on Flow Maps and this kind of sort of application. It's about 54 variables, so it's a pretty exhaustive review. It was the purpose of that was to get a kind of state of the art. Of what is available on web app application for doing flow maps, and we gathered it in a dashboard with developed with R-Shiny, which is already available at this URL. So it looks like that. You can see the data, the raw data. You can extract it with a CSV or X5 file, and you can also access to a dashboard to see some graphics about the data. You can also filter the data if you want to filter about it. So it's already available. In that corpus, I extracted maybe 7 variables, and then we'll speak about it. First one I want to show you is that about the licenses. Most of the application, we don't have information about the license, but for the one we get the information, we can see that there is a lot of them that are open source or libre, and a bunch of them are proprietary. So it's a good point for open source software. An example I can show you, maybe it's the Open Railway map, which is a map from OpenStreetMap data, but on the highway data, which is collaborative and open source. And on the other side, we have Strava, which is a proprietary application for to see athlete parkours, runners, and such. So we have this kind of application. We get data, we take snapshots of it. The context where whose applications are developed are often the private sector, by private companies and such. There is a bunch of work that are from the public sector and the research. So if we gather them, it's a big group. Some of them are collaborative, which like the one I showed you before. And some of them are from professional. So it's professionals who are doing that on our free time. One example I can show you, it's the Nîmes and Alès Urban Agency, which are cities in the south of France, who published a web application to show the commute between the cities at different times of the day. And the other end, we have the Global Trade Africa, which is a web application to visualize goods flows between Africa and mostly, you can see it, but it's Africa and China. The thematics used in that application are mostly about transport, migration, networks, and mobility, and others. But this is the most themes that are used in the application. For example, this is transportation data. It's a simulation of the transport services in Switzerland from GTFS data, GTFS data set. So it's bus services and the quantity of them in Switzerland. The different scales, most of applications use global scale. Some are national and regional, or local scale. Very few of them are multi-scale. We are developing currently the Arabesque web application, which is multi-scale in this case. We gave her the information on features provided by those applications. Some of them are very common, like zooming, panning, adding vector data. You can filter data often. And some of them are less common, like reprojection, transparency handling, change the administrative layout. And as you can see, we implemented common features, but also not so common features in the Arabesque application I will show you after. You can see that it's web apps, so most of them use JSON and the JSON family of data formats. A few of them use CSV. We choose to use CSV files for the flow maps, and some of GeoJSON for the nodes. You can add GeoJSON for the node in the application we developed. We also made a survey to say, okay, we have a state of the art, but what are people expecting from a new application? What will be interesting to have in the application? So we got 200 respondents to this survey. It was made in France. So it was in French. Most of them are from the public sector. 80% are from the public sector. 30% were from the research sector. So maybe it's a bias from the people we were able to touch. But maybe it's our community, as we are from the research side. And things that are interesting is that the more the three important tools they are using, two of them are free open source software. So mostly use QGIS, and they also use R to visualize the geospatial data, and they also use ArcGIS. So it's a good point for free open source software for geomatic. The thematics are similar, but what we saw before, it was about people transportation and goods transportation mostly. Some of them are interesting, like ideas circulation, and it's mostly how ideas circulate between researchers. And you can see some people working on mobile phone or ticketing technology and such. And yeah, maybe it's still a bias from the community we reached, but people wanted a free application and open source application, if possible. It was the most asked question features, even before an aesthetically pleasing representation or an application easy to use or fluid. So we ask them, what do you want as a graphic model? Mostly them asked flow maps. Some of them asked for CloudOpen maps. We can do flow maps in the web app we developed, not CloudOpen maps. It's a feature we will add. We can do a statical chart, simple ones, like bar plots and such. But we won't do network maps, graph, or vector field. This is not the goal for our application. So we developed an application we called Arabesque, which is a dance move. Yeah, it's a web application. It's developed with robust technologies like OpenLayers, D3GS and WebGL, Porch4JS to handle the projection part. It's still in beta testing stage. The beta testing stage is not open yet. And it's developed by one of your interns, which is an engineer and computer science student. It is in BSD2 closed license, so it's open source, even if the code source is not on a depot, which is public. So I can't show you a demo yet. It's not on a public server yet too, but I can show you a snapshot we did. The application is in three parts, two panels and a map. On the left panel, you can play with your layer, add new layer, transform them to another projection. There's currently around 15 projections available, and we plan to add more. You can add layers from GeoJSON or from base map from OpenStreetMap, and you can order and change the color scale, change the form of the arrows and such, or the link. And the right panel, you can add filter, so you can filter your data from information provided by your data, so maybe from the distance between each link, which is calculated automatically, or the count of your nodes. You can add your filter as well. This is a filter provided by default, but you can add your own filter. So maybe you can add categorical information you want to filter. And you can hide one or two of the side panel to show the map. So this is one of the kind of the representation you can do, like it's a curved triangle. And you can add also, when you got over a feature, you can add, you can get information about the feature. The final release is will take part at the Sageo conference in France in November this year. I hope we saw you there to get those information. To conclude, we use robust and well-known technologies to do that because we knew it would be easier and not to we don't get too much problem with it. It's focused on flow maps. It does, for now, it's just do flow maps, but it does it well. It's a unique combination of features, as we can we show before. And we paid great attention on graphics. So the graphics are pretty, and you can have pretty and nice maps with it. And last point, I like it, free and open source software. Thank you for your attention.